It wasn't, horses were his life. He'd done it for 60 odd years and he loved them. Started off as a jockey. He was always, he's known as the man of one-liners. And that was Mick down to the ground. He loved to see people laugh. He always had fun. He absolutely adored racing. Like I said, he just loved to see people laugh. He was always out there trying to get people's minds off everyday things that can be a problem.
Mick Mair was a champion bloke, as well as being a great trainer of good horses and also great humans as well. Mick Mair moved to the Sunshine Coast not long after Caulball Park was constructed and set about training many winners, including some premiership titles as well. Mick trained some really good horses. He had the Group 1 winner, Swiss Ace, and loads of star gallopers. One of my favourites was Dr. Zachary.
He used to say to me, how can you fight something that you can't see? So I can't say that he fought it. What I can say is that he battled cancer and he battled hard for us. He continued to try all the time. Every drug that was offered, he took, to the point where he was so sick and he just couldn't take it anymore. Some of the medications weren't working, but he battled so hard. He really did. They gave him 3 years. He promised me 5 years, and he lasted 4 years, 11 months, and 3 weeks. So I don't begrudge him that last week. He just battled so hard and was just such a precious man. He really was. Yeah, he was always there. Right up until Sunday, he went to the races and was still telling his jokes on the Sunday. But that's Mick. He was never going to cave easily. He was never going to give in easily. Every time the doctor said, you've got weeks or you've got months to go, he'd defy him and go another year. And I suppose you could say I thought that that would keep going forever, but obviously it didn't. Unfortunately, I'd give anything to do it all over again.
He always made you feel comfortable and made you feel welcome and let you build your confidence over time. And he often, you know, said that he was really pleased that, you know, with the relationship that we had. And yeah, I was very, very lucky to have had him in my corner a lot of the time. Yeah. His knowledge of racing and his memory recall was terrific. You know, there wasn't much that he missed out on. He always knew what was going on, but he'd always finish it off with a one-liner of some sort, and you know, always put you at ease as far as that goes. But a wealth of experience, wealth of knowledge.
Mick was a terrific bloke. Probably his greatest trademark was a wicked sense of humour. He would have you laughing in almost every conversation. Fitting at his funeral, that the final song that Mick chose, much to, I suppose, the delight of a very, very moving service, was Another One Bites the Dust, and only Mick Mair would have that.
Brandil stands out, Fist of Fury, and then Scenic Blast. Lucky Secret claimed the lead from Swiss Ace, Morgan Dollar, and then Scenic Blast flashing home. It's Lucky Secret in front of Swiss Ace. Lucky Secret, Swiss Ace kicks. Swiss Ace kicked again and beat Lucky Secret. Had him done to the world, but he's kicked back to win Swiss Ace.
He did win some good races with him, and he was quite proud of it. He could win an Oakley Plate down in Melbourne, or he could win a class race up in Gympie, and he'd be just as happy for his owners, and it was never about the glory.
Gave so much, but he was, you know, in the background. You know, he was not pushing himself out there or anything like that. He wasn't after the limelight, but he fronted up and did what he did, and yeah, he was always, you know, just there ticking along quietly, and you know, and obviously he got a thrill out of all the wins and successes and what have you, but I think he certainly enjoyed seeing things around the club progressing well too. He was always, you know, very positive about all those sorts of things. He was he always brought a positive aspect to pretty well everything that's gone on with the club, so which is great, yeah.
So many people have so many memories of what a beautiful person he was. He was just a happy person. He loved life, he loved his racing, he loved his horses. The friends that he got in racing were amazing, and they all stuck by him. Close friends, the good ones. He was just an amazing man.